And ain't it good to be in Grandma's kitchen?
Grandma's kitchen.
Let's get our aprons on. Get back up.
I can't remember.
Who was on the left?
You were on the left. And the one on the right was... What's that song?
Yeah, here we go.
Okay, we're trying
shifting gears.
Yeah, I know.
All right, what key is this in?
This key. I better have my hands on some
strings. Yeah, probably wash. Wash your hands.
What do you know with your rings on, Jason?
I am displaying my love for my wife.
Long wait for this.
Oh, yeah? Oh, is that right?
Oh, it was stuck there, wasn't it? I didn't try to hijack it. There we go.
Hi, everybody. How are you doing? I know. Aren't they awesome? Hi, Laura from British Columbia.
Oh, well.
Lots of great, great people.
So awesome.
Linda.
Yeah.
Yeah. They are both so great together. Men of many talent. Deborah Tite, she's from BC as well. That's awesome. Odette. Hi, Odette. Great. So many people that join in every week. It's so awesome.
It's awesome.
How do you keep up? I don't know how you keep up with all the comments.
I well, you know what? I never watch the comments unless I just walk up to the cameras. Can't see. But usually I'll catch a few comments at the end when, you know, sometimes I have tea at the end and whatever, and a bit of the product, which we won't be doing today, but we will have tea. But after, you know, sometime on Sunday evening, I sit down and I watch it. And I watch for anything that I can respond to and answer. I love just reading it and see where people are from. You know, like they're from Barbados and France and all over the U.S. and all over Canada. And I mean, just beautiful.
Awesome.
But they say reflecting on it with gratitude is the equivalent of a prayer.
Seriously?
Yeah. Oh. Reflecting with gratitude is like a prayer.
I love that.
I said that. I just said that.
Okay, guys. We're going to get into this. So dump your dough out on your surface.
Oh.
And I'm sorry, I took the tape off your parchment paper there, but we'll just...
Oh, that's okay.
Okay,
I'm
so...
I'm going to go here.
So dump it out.
Just dump it out. And you're going to cut it into three even pieces. So, sorry.
Mine landed a little bit sideways, too. I think you're screwing up, Jimmy.
Nope.
No, he's doing a great job, actually.
100%, thank you.
He's putting it straight.
Straight?
You know, okay. So into an even-looking piece of dough.
Okay.
That I know where thirds are. We're talking my thing right now.
This feels
This is my engineering background.
Yeah, I think you might have got mine. I just wanted to bring that back up again, that oil part.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Okay.
Come on.
Yeah,
beautiful.
That's really good.
And here you go.
It's really good.
So just in thirds.
How come this is bigger than mine?
I
don't make any jokes about that.
You're talking about my nose.
No jokes.
So,
my ears.
Put those over there, and you're going to take one at a time, and you're going to roll it into like a snake.
Yep.
Okay.
I read your instructions, but I need some guidance.
Okay, so...
How thick? What are we talking here?
Well, you know what? Make it as long as the hand.
Okay.
If that's a good guide.
That's going to take some work.
Depending on your hand. So it's probably going to be about 15 inches or so.
Listen, there's so many jokes we could be making right now with all this thing. What are we rolling out here?
Well,
it's a family show.
Do you know what? Jason, I'm going to give you a break. Jason,
look at this. Look.
I'm going to do this guy's first.
Because she's making it fair.
I'm actually going to take you over here so you can look down at the table and
let's
what
look at
they're
what
doing.
I'm doing. That's what you want
okay,
to see.
Okay, well follow okay. this guy. Okay, right. So what do you think?
Look at this, Jason. Guess who's on camera?
Okay, so put it here.
Okay,
and I'm just gonna
do your thing.
Do that. We're gonna kind of join them at the top with that. Okay, now do the second one.
I think I need one a little bigger.
We'll bring it over to this surface because it's up the way it is.
You should watch what I'm doing, Jason.
Oh no, I got my own style.
Oh, look at that.
See this? It's like old Italian style right here.
That is not the first time you've done this.
I look at this. I'm going to make pretzels instead of bread.
Yeah, and you can?
You could.
You could.
All right.
From there.
I think it's got to be a little longer.
Okay.
And you mean you can just, perfect. Okay, now just put that one like down the center.
Good.
Okay. And the next one.
Your socks.
Mine looks great. I'm gonna have like a real nice middle and
you're doing great, Jason, but that one in the middle is kinda little.
It is, isn't it? That's one I think.
If he had a nickel, first time
I
heard that.
I'm gonna borrow some from this one. There, like that. Put this one in. It's like Play-Doh. You can still just if you screw it up, you just go back and make another big mess again. Okay, there.
Jason grew up in school. He was doing Play-Doh in high school. You're in luck.
I still eat Play-Doh. My mom had to make me get the edible kind. So.
Okay.
He's so good at music, I have to make fun of him off camera.
All right. That sounds good. Okay. So, Jason, we'll get to you in a second.
Sure.
So, basically, we're going to combine the top a little bit. And now you're going to braid it. You know how to braid?
I know how to braid. I got a daughter.
Yep. Okay, I'll hold this down.
Maybe I don't.
That's good?
Yep.
Mine?
Always. Always come from the outside into the middle.
So, no, I don't know how to braid. Jimmie.
And then.
Were you ever a Boy Scout?
This one.
Sadly, yes, I taught the scouts.
And this from the outside into the middle.
To the middle?
And from the outside into the middle.
Okay.
It started connecting.
And from the outside into the middle.
Oh.
Okay. And same. The outside into the middle. And then just kind of tuck it together.
This way?
Yeah.
I'm trying to salvage this.
Well, this couldn't look any better.
We have more to do on this, but I'm going to just put this aside for now and get...
I'm going to need an engineer.
Come on over here. Bring it over to this, to here.
I'm not sure I want to show people this, but... I'm actually making a ribbon, like a reminder of herbs.
So my granddaughter's fifth birthday is today, and she could have done this.
You're doing good.
Yeah, it's coming along.
Here.
You. Okay.
I'll just stretch it a little bit. It doesn't matter in the end, anyway.
That's how I wanted
it. Can we put them side by side?
Now, I went like 90% alone, and you had the teacher's help.
And now just kind of tuck it in together.
See, look at that now.
Look at that.
Like, all right, I stand correct.
Like a Clydesdale's tail on the Budweiser.
Okay, so here we are.
I stand correct.
The two of them. So we're not finished yet. Okay.
Can we take votes online, Mitch?
Jimmie,
set that up.
Jimmie, I want you to...
Crack
an
no
egg.
No shells.
I cook.
But do you bake?
I'll take that. And now, and whip it up as well as you can. Now you guys don't have to make it into a braid. You can just have a free form of any kind. I just like the look of this.
If you want a braid worse than ours.
Okay. And
how's that?
That's great. And just let me get one more little stir to that.
Yeah. And that definitely needs another
He's a newer. That's the equivalent of the mom. Give me that.
Yeah.
Okay, so you just have one well-beaten egg here, and Jimmie and Jason are going to just take that. I'm using one egg over the...
So all of it?
Yep.
over the top of it.
Oh, nice.
And this will give it a nice finish.
So what does this do?
It just gives it a shiny finish when it comes out of the oven.
There's and enough oil in that other one.
Oh, but... I got a hair in my...
From your hat.
Oh, that's from the brush.
That was from your hat.
No, that's from your not hat.
You must have adjusted your
That's
your
from you
hat.
Not having a hat. That's what that's from.
Okay, that's beautiful.
I think we're good.
Now, Jason's turn. Will you give me the kosher salt there?
A hair net.
All right. And you just sprinkle a little bit of kosher salt.
Like a pinch type of thing?
Yeah, all over.
I think I just made scrambled eggs in the middle there.
Jason's making an omelet.
Yeah.
So I neglected to tell you to preheat your oven to 400.
Okay. Too late now.
But mine is preheated because I did that.
Is that good?
That's perfect.
That was a few passes.
That's perfect. So
I think mine's gonna be really shiny.
That's actually looking good, Jason. I gotta give you credit.
Yeah, it's egg in the hole actually right here.
It's all right.
And just pinch.
And just pinch some over it. You know, just as much as you want, and it can't hurt.
My son loves salt. He probably just dump this on there, but garlic salt might be good.
There you go. Huh? Now,
where's the garlic? What's going on here?
No garlic on the top.
All right, kosher garlic salt.
So, everyone, we're going to just set this aside for 15 minutes.
So why is that?
To let it raise a little bit more.
Okay.
And then when we put it in the oven, it'll be...
So how did you learn this? This recipe specifically?
Specifically?
How many times did you do this that you're comfortable doing this for thousands of people on the internet?
Not that many times.
Really?
No, it's just it as I need it, as I want to serve something. Like before Christmas, I made it to serve with lasagna.
Oh.
And then we have spaghetti a lot. I love Italian food, and this particular recipe, I probably just did it in December for the very first time.
Oh,
but
wow.
I made French bread before that without putting herbs in it. You know.
So would you change this up every time you did it?
No.
Like what you got written down. Are you happy with it?
I'm happy with it. I like it the way it is.
And she's not going to tell everybody about it.
So we're just going to let it sit like this for 15 minutes, and then they're going to be continuing to sing, and I am going to let it rise for another 15 minutes. Okay. And I'll put it in the oven. I'll come over to you and show you what it looks like. And I'll put it in the oven for about 25 to 30 minutes.
Perfect.
And as I've said before, but if you have a thermometer, it's a great thing to have. Like I have, I have a Pampered Chef thermometer, there's two probes on it. There's one probe. This is one we mostly use for meat. And the temperatures are right on there, and you just turn it on, and it'll give you a display of what the cooked item is. Or this one also has an extra probe on the back here that you can also just do it. And you can't have this one plugged in or this one won't work. It'll only read one or the other. And bread is cooked when you stick the probe in, and it registers about 190. If you want the perfect temperature for internally for bread, just like you would for meat or whatever, 190 is ideal. And when I cooked this one on Wednesday, I left it in for 30 minutes, and it came out and it was about 198.
Do you take it out before it's done because it will keep cooking afterwards? Or?
Yeah. I use my timer all the time. So I took it out at 30 minutes and I tried it, and it had already reached almost 198. So today I'm going to check it at 25 minutes and just see what it looks like. Okay, but for now, 15 minutes, we're going to let it rise. Mm. And pray to God that it's going to be awesome. You know, I
think we know who's winning this. I'm glad you didn't cook one.
Yeah.
Bake one.
Mm-hmm.
But I think we know what's going to happen here.
So I'm sure you guys want to hear some more music, so I'm going to let them take it away.
Jimmy's got some songs too, so
yeah.
That would be nice.
Okay, sir.
All right.
All right.
Phew. Oh, I'm good. I got the water straight up.
So you have viewers from, what's the farthest country that you've seen?
Australia.
Wow.
France, and a couple of people from Switzerland. There's a way that you can go in and look at where your people are from. So there's Hawaii.
So let's get comments here. Who's from where? How far away are you from Port Hood?
It usually takes a minute to come up.
Glace Bay, where are you?
Where's my Glace Bay?
Scotland.
Nice. Johnny Reed country.
Johnny Reed. Believe it or not, I was in a show with Johnny Reed.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, and yeah.
I got a kiss right on the cheek.
Nice.
Actually, it was his Christmas show when he was in Sydney.
Yes.
And Natalie was...
Sudbury, Windsor.
Playing with him. And they had old step dancers, moi.
Oh, yeah.
And young ones. And we did a part with Natalie. So that was pretty nice.
Alberta. Dundee. Just Dundee. Over the road. Niagara nice. Falls.
Cool.
Any Port Hooders out there, bud?
They're all out in the yard.
Grand Prairie, Boston.
In the yard.
Cool.
Pictou County. Barbados.
Wow.
Oh,
welcome.
God. She's a regular watcher, that lady from...
Deer Lake. Newfoundland.
My wife's from Newfoundland. Bishop Falls.
There's lots of Newfoundland.
Toronto, originally Glace Bay.
Oh, there we go. Glace Bay rules, capital of Cape Breton. I was actually born in Ottawa.
Okay.
And I lived there.
There it is, folks.
Yeah. And I'm not joking. So, I don't know if you guys knew Jack. So, Jack Bonaparte and I did a radio show, yes. East Coast Countdown.
Oh, yeah.
And so we had that for a long time. And literally, I grew up with Jack. And we did this radio show for a long time in the music scene. And then one day, we were just sitting around the house. It was since we moved here. And Krista and I were all, and Jack, I said something. I was like, well, I was born in Ottawa. And Jack was, I can't say exactly what he said online, but it was to the tune
distaste?
Of, get out of here. Something like that.
You weren't an official
and
Glace Bay.
He was disgusted
yeah.
that I wasn't born in Cape Breton.
Isle of Lewis.
Wow. Isle of Lewis. Oh, I bet you that's...
Nigeria. Does that say Nigeria? Nope.
Niagara?
Maybe Niagara. Might have been a typo there. Bray Shore.
I bet you that's. I bet you it's Jane McLeod from.
Gordy said, "I'm in the basement." Fort Mac.
Oh no, Port Favor.
Oh yeah, we
can the Winter
do that.
Blues.
Yeah. Port Favor, off the last one.
Yeah, give that little story about.
Reserve
oh my goodness.
That to him. Oh, the video was that.
Yeah, that one we. So I wrote this one down in Mexico, and. Still got it on my old phone, the little notes, little voice memos, where I was, you know, you hear the waves in the background and stuff, and I had it in my head. And anyways, then we decided we're going to shoot the video down in Mexico. So we had about, 80 people on a flight.
Well, we got the gig.
Yeah.
And they said, well, it was one of these, go down and see Jason Price in Mexico.
Yeah.
So him and I went down.
And Jimmie came down, and his wife and my wife and a bunch of family and friends, and then just people that want to see it. And so we play a couple of shows while there, but we're also going to shoot the video. And, well, in the video, my cousin is a super fan. We made it a comedy
scripted,
type
yeah.
thing, yeah. Mm-hmm. yeah. Mm-hmm. And anyways, it starts off, we're at the bar, and I'm going to take a shot of tequila. And Jason Price!
So Darcy's running up to Jason.
Yeah.
Oh my God, it's Jason Price!
Yeah.
And we had to do like 20 takes. He's drinking legit tequila.
It's real tequila. Yeah, we're redoing this, and it's in front of everybody. And I'm
and we're at the resort, literally out by the pool.
Yeah.
At the bar, at the resort, doing this, and everyone's looking at us like, "Who are these people?" Right? We had this one guy, I got this tiny little camera shooting Darcy, running up to him. Oh my God, it's Jason Price. But what happened was, throughout the rest of the week, everyone's like, hey, it's Jason Price. We convinced everyone there that he's like super famous.
So that's all you gotta do. If you go somewhere, bring a camera and act like it.
Bring a camera and a cousin.
Yeah,
we'll treat him like
you
a superstar.
Are a superstar.
There you go.
But he was drinking legit tequila.
Yeah, and I may or may not have fell in the pool.
He 100% fell in the pool.
Yeah. Oh man. Yeah.
Walking along, doing this. Chatting, hey, and literally went chuck into the pool. Didn't have the cowboy hat on though.
Thankfully. Yeah. Goes like this.
Sitting here in Mexico, drinking up the sun. Stress I had was melted by the end of day one. I had a kiss for breakfast and I changed it with a beer. Man, I really think I like it down here. I can't believe that it's Wednesday. Half my time is gone. Vacation's going faster than this drink I'm sipping on. Jose, Louie, and Pedro know what I'm gonna say. I hear them start the blenders as I stumble away. Margarita, Senorita, don't forget the salt and lime. Mirror glasses on my face with the scenery so fine. I'm only down here for a week. I got one thing for sure. Want a little more pour for four. Just a little more pour for four. So chilling on a beach chair, lotion on my skin. Locals out there fishing as the waves keep going in. I smell the shrimp I'm cooking, the warm night draws near. This really is a good life down here. I can't believe that it's Friday. Give me all my time is done. Vacation's going faster than this drink I'm sipping on. Jose, Louie, and Pedro say, amigo, you stay. I'm still in my cabana as my plane all flies away. Margarita, senorita, don't forget the salt and light. Get her glasses on my face, cause the scenery is so fine. Hold me down here for a week, I got one day for sure. Want a little more pour for four, just a little more pour for four. Margarita, senorita, don't forget the salt and lime. Mirror glasses on my face, cause the scenery's so fine. I'm only down here for a week, I know one thing for sure. Want a little more pour for more. Margarita, senorita, don't forget the salt and lime. Mirror glasses on my face, cause the scenery's so fine. I'm only down here for a week, I know one thing for sure. Want a little more pour for more.
Man, is that Jimmy Buffett? No, that's Jimmy Inch.
God, that was great.
That's fun stuff, eh?
That's a good tune.
Awesome. Yeah, that one's on the first one.
Little Southern Tone.
Grit, Guts, and Country Pride, that's the album. Actually, I'll leave a few, I have some CDs on. I'll leave some for you to give away to whoever you want.
Oh, a couple people were asking, actually, if they sold CDs. So
actual CDs.
Logistically, I don't know
physical
how
copies,
we might
look
at that. But
So how do people order a physical CD from you?
They go right to my website, the jasonpricecountry.com, and there's a place in a store in there that they can just order it, and but I'll leave a couple to give away to your
that would be lovely.
You can run a whatever you
want.
Yeah,
I can have a little
trivia night.
Yeah,
show pictures of your bread.
Yeah.
They make great coasters.
Porpoise.
Yeah.
What about the 5Ws or something like that off the new record? Yeah.
Yeah.
So you got the new record. So he won't brag about it, but the new record is fantastic.
It is.
I had nothing to do with it.
Yeah. Yes, you did. Yeah.
But don't forget the song that I want.
Yes, we'll get to that one.
Yeah.
Too.
And you got to give Jason Berry a shout out.
Huge.
On
so
this.
Jason is Dean Brody's lead guitar player, but beyond that, he's in the Hall of Fame for the CCMA as a guitar player. He can't win Guitar Player of the Year anymore because he won it too many times, so they put him in the Hall of Fame.
Mm-hmm.
And producer extraordinaire. He does stuff with YTV and all Tennille Arts just recently. He's just a real down-home nice guy. And just by weird connection, he played in my uncle's band. It was his first band growing up. He's from my mom's hometown. Yeah, and so we ran into each other at an airport, and I had him on Facebook as a friend. I'm like, "You're Jason, right?" And he goes, "Yeah, you're Jason." Yep, and then just went from there, and just a super, super nice guy. And Jimmie came over, and we, when the musicians were there, the studio guys, it's actually Dean's band, the Brodeo, they call them. And,
oh, cool.
Yeah, and they're fantastic guys and great musicians, and he set all that up, and Jimmie and I went over and watched as they gave life to the demos that we put down, and then added some vocals to it.
It was, I've been in the studio, and you'll get a kick out of this, Mitch. It was like, I've been in the studio a long time and done a lot of recording projects, and, you know, thought I was good at it.
You are good at it.
And then I got to Barry's studio, Barry Tones in Miramichi,
yep.
And Dean Brody's guys roll in as a band. And we had done the demo tracks in Myra at my buddy's place. And we were like, oh, it's perfect. It's a perfect record.
Yeah.
Right? So we used those as the demo tracks for his new album. And so we engineered turned out to be the demo. We thought it was going to be a live record just for a laugh.
Mm-hmm.
But it turned out to be the demo. And so we got to New Brunswick, and Jason Berry had already laid the new guitar tracks down. Dean Brody's guys roll in the day we get there. And Mark, the bass player, comes over to me. He's like, "So what do you do?" I'm like, "I play bass with Jason." He goes, "You play bass in the record?" I'm like, "No, you're playing bass in the record.
Mm-hmm.
I'll learn what you do." But it would have only been ego for me to say, "Well, I'm playing on the record."
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of times what people don't realize, like a lot of studio musicians will have a studio, or touring musicians will have studio band
mm-hmm.
come in and be the record.
Yeah. Behind it.
And the touring players will learn those parts.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
I understand. Yeah. Okay.
Right? So these guys are, if the studio is different than stage. If you're good in the studio, as you guys all know, if you're good in the studio, it doesn't mean you're good on stage.
True.
Right? Mm-hmm. So you could be out there being the front guy and just banging out the guitar and stuff, but you might not be the best rhythm guitar player to play on the record.
Right.
So with his new record, case in point. No, anyway, not to hijack the story, but he ended up using Dean Brody's guys as a band, and they come in that studio, they took the clipboards, and they listened to the demos, and it was almost like, "Okay, so what are we doing here?" And Barry's like, "Okay, here's the first one, it's in G." And they hit play, and the boys are like, writing out how the song goes. "So you take that, okay. And then they went and did it, live from the floor. All in different rooms.
Oh yeah, it's like a magic trick.
And I
can do it.
I've been very, very fortunate over the years to record with a lot of people, and either on camera or in the band, I had never seen anything like that. It was like, oh, that's a thing.
Yeah. So huge,
that's
huge.
Amazing.
Yep. Thanks to him, he.
You'll have to give us a song too before the show's
over. Yeah, Jimmy's got a lot of his own stuff there.
Do you know what? I'm gonna let my bread be my
don't
my
do that.
Metal here.
You better actually probably play a song.
No, do you know what? Honestly, it's, and I get this question a lot just because of, like, in the Highland Heights days, and I did TV way before Mitch did. No, but there was, joking aside, like I really enjoy playing with Jason and being kind of the band guy who's on stage chatting with the other guy. Okay, here, this is coming up, and it's kind of the band leader, like the captain of the band type of thing. He's the guy, but you need somebody you know what it's like. You're on stage. You need somebody to be walking around calling the shots. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I enjoy that way more now than being the front guy. Mm-hmm. I did the front guy thing.
Yeah.
And now when we play shows, we're done the set. I keep walking. He has to shake hands and kiss babies.
Yeah.
And I don't have to do that.
Yeah.
So I literally, I don't. I haven't written songs in a few years. I really like the role that I'm doing and the videos and the multimedia stuff and the podcast. I'd prefer to do that. It's a choice. So literally, I don't have new tunes. I'm going to do a new record this year, but it's still in process. So I musically right now, I just like playing with him, playing with Jerry and the boys, and not having to worry about my kids are, my granddaughter's 5, my kids are 14, 17, so I'm busy with that. I don't have time to worry about what he has to worry about.
And you both have full-time jobs.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
Day jobs.
Luckily. Luckily. Yeah.
It's not everybody who releases a record just before COVID.
During COVID. Dumb.
I thought it just came out in August.
August, yeah. Yeah,
oh, so. Well, that's right in the middle.
Yeah.
But for some reason, I thought first that it was March.
So I had a single, When Music Was Enough, came out. I thought it would be a genius idea to release When Music Was Enough to radio in end of December.
Okay.
And that is not a genius idea because all the radio people are on vacation.
So. Oh, okay.
So don't do that, indie music people. And anyway, so I released that one ahead of the album. And then I might have put another one out ahead of the album. I can't remember. And then when COVID came out, there was one song that just wasn't, it was a duet. And we needed somebody, it was Jen Shepherd.
Oh, yes.
And we needed someone to record that. And Jen was awesome. She took that
beautiful.
And went. And,
beautiful voice.
Yeah, and powerhouse singer. Anyway, she had a studio that she could go to, I think Lakewind.
Fred Lakewind.
Yeah, so... And she sent her stuff over to Jason in New Brunswick. And so we weren't allowed to go around anywhere. So that kind of held things up. And then it went to Nashville for mastering. And then by the time I got my hands on it, it was like, do I release it or do I wait? And I got so much tied up in it that I'm just putting it out. I don't know how long COVID's going to be. So couldn't tour it, but now we're doing a mini tour.
Yeah.
We're here.
There you are. Here now.
But honestly, this is the new reality for playing live. Like, we're going to hit.
Sure.
You know, so if you get hundreds on the live stream and then thousands on the replay on YouTube for this, how many shows would you have to play live for 50 people?
That's right.
To get the same amount of views?
Yes, mm-hmm. True. Mm-hmm.
To get what we're doing out there. It doesn't make sense. Right? So we're coming back here every week.
Yes.
We're going to backpack on your platform.
Yeah.
Glad you're here.
Jason and Jimmy's tunes.
Take it over. What do you got?
Let's try that. The 5 W's. This is one that we put out on the new album. 27 is the new album. So I keep saying the new
this
album.
This wasn't good enough for the first record.
But it's that's funny. This was scratched from the first record, but resurrected. Don't know why I do the things I do. Guess I'm still working it out. I try to be a good man the way my dad taught me to. But lately I travel the wrong route. Well, I got an angel on gone 10 years, but I think I heard her bad this time. I could blame it on whiskey, honky-tonks and beers. But I know that I'm still gonna pay for my crimes. And I think I'm getting sentenced tonight over who I am.
sixteen on here. Yeah, I could plead the fifth, but it's on my face. I think I'm gonna pay for this for you over who I live with.
Singing that, the buzzer went off, oh. So the 15 minutes was up.
Okay.
And I've put both of the loaves in the oven.
Did you put the good one in and the bad one?
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
So, and I set it for 25 minutes.
25
and
minutes.
I will check at 25 minutes. So.
Hopefully there's not an oil fire in that oven.
Yeah.
What was the first song you ever learned?
Oh, well... It was,
I don't think I ever asked you that.
Yeah, I believe, now I can't remember if it was the one or the other. If it was George Jones, He Stopped Loving Her Today, or Keith Whitley, Don't Close Your Eyes. So it was one of those two. Yeah,
that's an awesome.
I think we should hear both. We got 25 minutes.
Oh,
what's going on?
Yes.
Try.
Yes.
Why wouldn't you?
Oh my God.
I know you love me a long time ago. Even now in my arms, you still want him, I know. But darling, this time, let your memories die. Don't close your eyes. close your eyes. Let it be me. And don't pretend it's him in some fantasy. Darling, just once let yesterday go. You'll find more love than you've ever known. Just hold me tight.
Same key, but so let's go slow.
So do you find her going from, so you just played that in the same key?
Yeah.
And then do you find her going from that to a similar one? Do you find that, Mitch? But if you're playing something in the same key?
Absolutely.
And the melody's stuck in your head from the last one?
Yeah.
Well, now it is. It's like asking, can you see your eyes in the back of your glasses?
I can't now, thank you. But now I do that all the time. There's certain songs I can't do back to back.
Oh, really?
Because of the melodies. And the strumming pattern might be a little different, but close enough where it just throws you off and you just can't do it.
Yeah.
So good luck.
Yeah, thank you. He said, I love you till I die. She told him, you forget me in time. And as the years went on by, he still prayed on his mind. He kept some pictures on his wall. Went half crazy now. He still loved through it all. Hoping she'd come back again. Kept some letters by his bed. Dated 1962. He had underlined in every single I love. Thank you.
He stopped loving her today. They place a wreath upon his door, and soon they'll carry him away. He stopped loving her today.
Probably my favorite country song.
It's a great song. Right?
Yeah, what a song.
So at the end there, that riff is a running joke with us.
Yeah, he keeps
after every song, it's like the country riff.
Country song, he throws that on at the end.
Yeah. So it's just a running joke that we do it after.
Absolutely.
I think that was song of the year 2 years in a row.
Oh, really?
Oh, really?
2 years in a row.
Wow.
I mean, like his late one year.
Yeah.
Great song.
He, I know he didn't want to record it. He said, nobody's going to buy that morbid SOB or something like that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What was the story with George Jones? Somebody was opening for him. Or he was opening.
Buck Owens.
Was it Buck Owens or something? Yeah. Because George Jones had a...
He had a mean streak.
He had a mean streak about him, right? So what was the story with... They were on tour or something.
Yeah, and Buck was the biggest thing going. And George was opening for him every night. And he got sick of it. He said, how about let me close out the show? He's like, nope, you go on. You go on first. I'm the headliner.
So Buck Owens is telling this to George Jones.
To George Jones. So George went out and did Buck Owens' whole set. It got off the stage. I was like, what a lot of guts to do.
Can you imagine
doing that to somebody?
What?
And he still had a career.
Yeah. Now, you read a lot of... like biographies and music stuff. What was the best one? If you were to recommend somebody, like you're a country guy, obviously.
Oh man,
the Willie Nelson one was really good.
Was really good. Merle's was really good. I really like Merle's. I read Randy Travis's too, and that was an eye opener. What he went through. And
yeah, you never saw that one coming.
Yeah, there was a lot of stuff that I feel really bad for him. You know, Randy Travis. He basically got all his money taken from him, and he was really restricted on what he knew. So, but a bunch. I'd recommend buying anybody's because you get the whole story on how they got there. You know, it's pretty awesome.
My favorite part of the Willie Nelson one is he drops Gordy Sampson's name.
Does he?
In the book.
Hey.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Gordy wrote something that Willie did. But so near the end of the book, he drops Gordy's name.
That's right.
In the book. I think with Guy Reed, maybe? Or did Guy Reed? Guy Reed's a physio.
My memory's horrible.
What's the name of the song?
Picture Without You, me?
No.
My
no.
Favorite picture of you?
Happy. Well, Gordy wrote that. I know that one. Yeah. There's a funny one that he wrote. Clark. He's kind of a comical one. The Songwriters. That's what it's called.
Oh, okay.
Really?
Yeah, I think you're right.
Have you heard that before?
Yeah.
I don't think I heard that one. I heard It's All Going to Pot. That was a good one.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Gordy wrote one that made Willie's latest album.
Yes, it did. Now
I think it's called The Songwriters.
Yeah.
And it's just kind of about the songwriters that are in backstage of these performers that are out front. You know what I mean? And
quite literally millions of songs written just in Nashville alone. Like, can you imagine how many songs are written? Mm. Oh, man.
Yeah.
Like
and like great songs that people have never heard.
Yeah, or people won't record because I didn't write it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. It's weird.
Yeah.
That reminds me of that Lacey J. Dalton song.
16th Avenue.
Yeah.
You know that one?
I don't
think I know that one.
You never heard that song?
I don't listen to the radio.
God bless the boys.
I know what Jason tells me.
16th Avenue.
Oh, okay. No, I don't think I know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, maybe.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You
know what? Maybe I did.
We'll have a tune.
I probably know.
We'll listen to it a bit later.
God bless the boys who make the noise on 16th Avenue.
Yeah.
We'll play it after.
Sounds good.
Okay. What was the one you wanted to hear earlier?
Oh, hold it.
Gotta get it.
What key's that in?
Yeah.
We haven't played this.
I don't think
in forever.
I may not know this.
Let's try it though.
Alright.
Trying to get a handle on holding you. It's tearing me up. It won't turn me loose. I keep running into walls I can't break through. I'm trying to get a handle on holding you. Thank you.
might think you're too little bit crazy, baby. Let me tell you why I won't give up. Seems like every time I try to lately, I just fall a little more in love. First time, last thing on my mind. Daytime, nighttime, baby, I'm trying to get a handle on holding you. It's tearing me up, it won't turn me loose. I keep running into walls I can't break through. I'm trying to get a handle on holding. Like that, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. That's the Garth Brooks way to do it. If you just play a little, like a verse,
little,
or, yeah, little taste.
But the beauty of the beauty of COVID online stuff now is you can do this. Ah, there you go. There's a little bit. That's what we know.
Right. That one leads into the other one too. So, like I said, my favorite is George Jones, and my favorite beer was Bud Light. I haven't been drinking many beers lately, but
Jason's on a diet.
Yeah, kind of kicked him for a while.
So I've been making up the slack.
So, but I do drink Budweiser Zero. In place of Bud Light, for now.
Maybe Bud Light will sponsor the next Tunes and Wooden Spoons.
Well, they should.
Keith McNamara is watching this, I guarantee you.
Yep.
Keith. At LeBanc.
From Sydney.
Focus on. What do you want, Cecil? Somebody else from
Blue Lobster.
Hook us up.
Yeah. Nova Scotia Spirit Cult. We'll have to sponsor the next one.
So on the first album, as a throwback to George, $2 pistol.
Bring that beer.
What's that jangling I had come my way? Someone carried a case of my favorite drink. Listen to the cooler feeling with ice swinging rain. Have a big time. I always love the sound of a cold Bud Light. So crack me a cold one. It sounds like all my troubles disappear. Let's kick back. Let's have fun. Listen as I open up my favorite beer. What's that shape of night on my way? Someone carried a case of my favorite drink. Listen to the cooler feeling with ice springing rain. Have a big time. I always love the sound of a cold Bud Light. It's much easier to be alone and do it than I'm not great with co-writing. What I'm great with is maybe doing a
look at that. Fucking runner up.
I like getting the song partly done or receiving one that's partly done, and then I can finish it or someone else can finish it if I don't go right through the process. But if I'm home with the kids a lot, and that's kind of the this whole thing too with this pandemic, is I'm home with the kids.
What are you people still doing in the house?
March, and leave me alone so I can write my song. Yeah, but it's I wrote a few over the past.
I think a cool writing story, if you're asking about him writing.
Yeah.
We were going to ECMA's in St. John of Brunswick.
Yeah.
And Jason was going up a day or two early because he was in a songwriter circle, and the band was coming up afterwards to do the showcase.
Yeah.
So we get there early, and we rented a house, was it? Yeah, it was a house.
It was a
Airbnb.
It was like a old motel almost, or apartment complex, I think, the apartment complex, and they converted it.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so he goes up the night before. We get there, he goes up on like on a Wednesday, does his show for the Songwriter Circle, and we go up on Thursday or Friday, and he's like, I wrote this new song the night before. So, like he was saying, being alone, so he's sitting there alone in this hotel room that reeks like cigarettes. It's like it wasn't a great, like the curtains were all yellow and...
The orange shag carpet from
1970s. I know this song, and the flowers.
Yeah,
spray.
Yeah, so...
But so, from what I've heard this story before, so what I understand, you took those key elements and then wrote a backstory of a relationship behind it.
Yeah, I just kind of pictured where I was, and so I was in this kind of like motel, and I just kind of pictured the story, like this... Someone coming up knocking, or hoping that you're, you know, maybe she's here, kind of thing, and then it just evolved. Like it, I don't know how it all happens eventually, but eventually the story comes together. You know, so it's this one, yeah, that one was.
Yeah,
we might as well play it, I guess.
That's a really good song. Listen to it.
It's kind of a songwriter song.
You doing G?
A. Yeah.
A.
Yeah. The riff might be in like capo. See you again. Nice.
awesome.
Yeah. We've been transit admission here.
I think it's almost moment of truth time here. The bus just went.
Where did it go?
I'm just gonna test it out here.
We got the temperature going.
Somebody's a step ahead of you, Mom, because I seen a comment there. Just took the bread out of the oven, and it looks frickin' wicked.
Oh, that's... Was that Alan Doyle? Wicked.
Wicked.
Yeah. So, it's coming in at 187, so I'm going to leave it in for the last 5 minutes.
Okay.
Is one looking a little oilier than the other?
Is one sweating a little bit?
The right is a little more brown.
Yes! That's mine.
They're both looking pretty awesome, actually.
What else we got? We should do that Seven Spanish Angels. We did the Seven Spanish Angels one time. Yeah, and at home.
Just for a laugh.
Yeah,
what
and then. And then, we did it one show, and it was like, we should probably add this. So, yeah.
Absolutely. Well, yeah, some songs will just take off.
Yeah.
Yeah, we started doing shows.
He looked down into her brown eyes and said, say a prayer for me. She threw her arms around him, whispered, God will keep us free. Well, they could hear the riders coming. He said, this is my last fight. If they take me back to Texas, they won't take me back alive. And there were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They're praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. The seven Spanish angels took another angel home. She reached down and picked the gun that lay smoking in his hand. She said, Father, please forgive me. I can't make it without my man. And she knew the gun was empty. She knew she couldn't win. But her final prayer was answered when the rifles fired again. There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, and there was thunder from the floor. Seven Spanish angels, if another angel.
Took another angel home.
smoke cleared, and there was thunder from the throne. And seven Spanish angels took another angel home. And seven Spanish angels took another
Jimmy,
that's 100% mine.
No, I think.
I'll show it in a second. I'm putting the lasagna in.
Oh. You should mention that mom made an apple crisp while you guys were playing.
Oh, really?
Is that right?
Yeah. I saw her peeling apples over there.
In like 7 minutes.
Wow.
Apple crisp while we're playing. It just happened just like that, like a Disney trick. So, mm-hmm. Yep, the real deal.
You're like a magician when they do this, yeah. They go.
Yeah.
You got an apple crisp.
Well, hope you liked today. Here are their creations.
Oh yeah.
That one's mine.
No. This one is Jimmy's. And this one is Jason's.
I haven't tasted them yet.
Keep it there, keep it there.
In an hour, we may have a bite of one of them or the other. So I hope you enjoyed this afternoon. We sure did. We're going to get one more song in a second to take us out. But before we do that, I just wanted to say that next week, we are going to be making mini cheesecakes with a raspberry sauce, or you can have the trusty old caramel sauce and make that ahead of time for it, the caramel sauce, that Mama's caramel sauce that's on the website. But the raspberry sauce is delicious and doesn't take very long at all to make it. And the little raspberry tarts makes just 12, and it'll be really, really great. And next week is February 28th, and next Sunday, it's just going to be you and I. And
Jason, are coming back.
Are you coming back?
We're coming back on Sunday.
So lots of time for chat and talk and how are you doing, and a cup of tea and a little mini cheesecake. So thank you all very, very much. I think there's going to be a... lots of comments on this beautiful show, and we have this talent, like, just among us here. So please do support these guys and like and follow their page. And Jason's new album is there for download, as is his other one as well. And I have to go back and correct something that I said. I didn't know, at the start of taping this message came up on Facebook about these stars. And our daughter just informed us that, Mom, it takes you to an app and people have to pay for however many stars you want.
Oh,
so Facebook gets you one way or the other. And I didn't mean for that. I just thought it was going to be a star that you could... just hit, and for somehow that registered with them. But wouldn't you know it, they're looking for money. So forget I said that, and I'm sorry if I took you to the wrong spot there. So we're going to enjoy this bread in about an hour, and the guys are probably taking the most of it with them, but we'll have a little bit with our lasagna. And I'm enjoying the company of these fellows for supper. And it'll be great because they have a long trip ahead of them to go back to Halifax tonight and be at work tomorrow. So I want to sincerely, sincerely thank you all for joining me. And I want to thank Jason and Jimmy for being here and for giving us just the funnest afternoon just with their antics and their
antics.
Conversation and their singing. I'm sure we'll have another couple of hours here with them too that will bring some more laughter to our kitchen.
Get to join us for this one.
Thank you, everybody. Yeah, everybody's thanking you for a wonderful afternoon. And I see Avon there. Hi, Avon. I got your card. Thank you very, very much. That was very special. So anyway, as I always love to say, thank you for joining me. Love one another and know that you matter to me and I love you. Have a wonderful week, and I'm going to turn it over to these guys for one last one.
Thanks so much. It's so nice.
So we got Mitch sitting in with us for this one. So is there any shout-outs we missed? Jillian, you're awesome. Thanks for watching.
Yeah.
Your folks, we shouted out.
We did, I think. My Uncle Gerald is probably out there somewhere.
Yeah. Everyone Lake Echo at my mom's place.
I seen him comment.
Oh, yeah. Oh, right. Okay, yeah. Yeah. Okay.
And Krista and the kids.
Yes.
And happy birthday to my granddaughter Violet, 5 years old today.
Alex and Abby, they're in there.
Not Adam and Regan.
Adam and Regan.
Nothing for you guys.
Luke and Blake. Yeah. Jeez, the credits are going to roll. We're going to.
They are. All right.
Thank you.
your love all the time. Oh, that's cool. This Tennessee whiskey is
beautiful.
You're as sweet strawberry wine. You're as on your love all the time. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. You're as sweet as strawberry wine.
That's it, folks. Love you all. Bye-bye.